personal na interes para ilihim ang katotohanan. May kasabihan tayong mga Pilipino. Ang sinungaling ay kapatid ng magnanakaw. Hindi ko matatanggap ang iyong sorry. Sinira mo ang pagtitiwala ng mga kababayan mo sa iyo. Wala kang karapatan na mamuno. You have stolen the presidency not once but twice.
That famous face uttered that famous phrase more than 5 years ago. And if things go as people behind the revelations of Lintang Bedol and Zaldi Ampatuan about the 2004 and 2007 polls hope, Susan Roses might just get history rewritten. Joining us on the phone is the daughter, Fernando Poe Jr., a presidential candidate in 2004, of course, who some people believe actually won the election, like General Gudani here. Good evening, Grace Polia Manzares. Good evening, Grace. Thank you for joining us.
Hi, good evening, Ms. Pia. Thank you for this opportunity.
Yeah. Well, Grace, I'm sure you given your character, no, you don't want to get ahead of events, no? But tell us first, very briefly, what were your first thoughts when Lintang Bedol surfaced and when he talked about allegations of cheating in the past?
Well, you know what? When I first heard about it, the first statement he made was there was cheating in 2007. And at that moment, he didn't mention it in 2004. And I sort of said a prayer to myself that hopefully he will also come out and mention 2004. Because I believe that a lot of us believe that's really the root of a lot of what's going on, what happened succeeding after the Ilugarte takes and all the issues. So now that he's actually come out, we are hopeful, but at the same time, we are also cautious because... first of all, there's always a question about his character. Mm-hmm. On the other hand, sometimes cases are actually won because you have somebody from the inside who actually participated in the crime, but who knows the inner workings of the conspiracy or whatever happened. So, as I said, we are hopeful, but at the same time, we are being also very careful. We're keeping our hopes in check.
Mm-hmm. You put it very very nicely, no, Grace. Na parang yung public sentiment now is partly cautious dahil nga hindi natin siguro alam, no, where this is going to lead us. At the same time, hopeful na sana magka-closure na, parang ganun, no? Do you sense that?
Yes, you know what? Actually, I had a discussion with a journalist earlier. And they were saying, how come now that he's come out, people are actually paying attention? Whereas in the past, we've had several witnesses, but to no avail. And I think the reason really being is that he was one of them. And the people who were coming out before and speaking about allegations and cheating were actually people who we expected to speak about it, people who were aligned with the opposition. Mm-hmm. So right now, hopefully... He's an insider. We're not thinking, I don't believe that his intentions are altruistic in any way. But I hope that the courts will be able to decide, given the circumstance, what the best situation would be with regards to dealing with him. Because I believe that the Maguindanao mass massacre actually happened because of the brazenness of the leaders in Maguindanao, because they know that they are owed a lot for what they've done in 2004.
Grace, if or when the country decides to go down this road, this is not going to be a walk in the park. No? This may just be a very long and painful journey, because after all, we're going back several years, and then, the search for truth, quote-unquote, is not always a pleasant trip, no? down memory lane, no? What do you foresee, as far as your mother are concerned, and the camp of your father?
You know what? We've seen the worst of it. I believe. I hope I'm not wrong about this, but we've seen the worst of it because for many years we've been trying to get people's attention to focus on the 2004 election. On the other hand, now we have this opportunity. What we're trying to see here now is that with the new administration, hopefully they will give this a fair trial or perhaps the proper forum to be aired and to be assessed and judged. Here's the thing. In the past administration, they hid behind technicalities and legalities. I'm hoping that whoever will be in charge of this, whether it be a probe or whether it be in the regular courts, that they will actually look at the law, the spirit of the law, and not just hide behind technicalities. Because once you do that, there will always be a clever lawyer out there who will twist things around. And if you allow that to happen, it will drag on forever without any closure.
Okay. What is your end goal here? Is this something that you and your mother have thought of? Because, I mean, of course, your father has passed on. 2004 to 2010 is over, no? So ano yung gusto niyo sana mangyari?
Well, our goal here, of course, personally, we would like him declared as the winner of the 2004 elections. But if we have to be pragmatic, if we have to be practical about it, a lot of the evidences were actually either stolen, lost, or burned. It would be so impractical to try and retrieve all of that. I don't even know if it's possible at all. So for us, even if you don't have to investigate every single area, although all of those allegations of fraud is as important as the other, but just to come out with significant findings that will be enough to put them away or that will be enough to convict them, I think that for us would actually be some sort of, justice. Because you know what, it would be nice if in the history books of our children we can see, okay, so the president who actually sat in office is GMA, but there will be an asterisk because of fraud and electoral violations. She was actually convicted of whatever, and here's the punishment. It's an example to be learned. And then whoever will try to do that will be more careful and hopefully will be discouraged to do the same thing.
And hopefully we come out a better people. After this, you know, whatever, wherever this road leads us. Anyway, thank you very much.
Thank you. You're welcome.
Thank you. Grace Polio Manzares, FBJ's daughter. Maraming salamat.
Unang-una, yung mga accountable forms, katulad ng balota, katulad ng election return, na naibigay din sa Maguindanao FA. Pag fake ang election return na ginamit mo, pwede mo yung palitan anytime. Anytime at twist ng another fake also, pwede mo palitan yan. Kung genuine naman ang ginamit mo, it takes another resolution in bank to get another copy. But this time, that election return that will be allotted to you will be bearing another serial number. Hindi yun ang gusto nila. Whoever use a fake election return, that's like a fake documents to win an election, also fake.
Noong time na yun, nasa century ako, dumating sila. Sabi ko, saan kayo galing? Sabi niya, galing kami sa Makati dahil pinatawag doon sila.
Nino po?
Si First Gentleman Arroyo.
Apo. Sino po ang pinatawag?
Yung tatay ko, pati si Engineer Nori Unas.
Apo.
Then, ang instruction sa kanila is kung paano isiro si President Pinoy na dating tumagmong senador. Si Senator Lito Cayetano at saka si Senator Ting Lacson.
Sa lalong madaling panahon tapusin na nila kasi every day na merong kumikilos na senador na hindi naman pala totoong nanalo is really an injury or damage to the Filipino people.
Dapat hindi umupo bilang senador, di dapat hindi din siya umupo bilang senador dahil meron po tayong napatunayan na na-benefit po siya dito sa dayana ng nangyari sa Metro Manila.
The cast of characters there, Lintang Bedol, Zaldi Ampatuan, Coco Pimentel and Mig Zubiri. So with us here in the studio is retired Marine General Francisco Gudani. Also joining us tonight is Dean Amado Valdez, the University of the East College of Law. Good evening. Dean Valdez, thank you for being here.
Good evening.
Dean, what should... Well, let's tackle very briefly na muna. Yung kaso ni Migs at ni Coco, oh. Migs Zubiri and Coco Pimentel. What should Mig Zubiri do?
Well, that's a good question because Mig should show that... If he thinks that there is taint in his election, then the most reasonable way and honorable way to do is perhaps to resign from his position.
Okay, but you know, in his press conference, he did say, na, in so many words, no, I'm not going to give a direct quote. Parang hindi ko naman hiningi, no, I did not ask to be beneficiary of this. Parang ganon. I did not ask people to make.
Well, it could be considered as a self-serving statement. Pwede mo nang sabihin yun because no one would be admitting that he's a party to such kind of shenanigans in the electoral process. And in fact, it would be incriminating himself if he would admit that he participated in the cheating.
Wala namang aamin ano. Oo. But the way you talk, you're Dean of College of Law, and I mean you're a renowned legal expert. You seem convinced that indeed there was?
Because even the counts, I think, has already favored Coco Pimentel. So what is left now is just the resistance on the part of Senator Zubiri to hang on to his post. Usually when there are charges, serious charges against a person, the best option sometimes is to file a countercharge in order to delay the proceedings. So, Coco Pimentel is right. The Senate Electoral Tribunal should expedite disposing of this case because the people are waiting that their votes or the mandate will be followed, which is the mandate that was the result of the election.
Yeah, okay. Well, anyway, that's the small, parang small circle, big circle, yung small circle, yung Migs Coco 2007. Of course, the bigger issue here is what really happened in 2004. You have Lintang Bidol surfacing and reports of other people who just might do the same thing. No? What is your analysis, Dean, of the situation? Is this really... kumbaga search for the truth, talagang lumilitaw na ba talaga yung katotohanan or may nagmamanipulate para ma-distract ang tao sa away from
the
zona?
It has a life of its own. These revelations have a life of its own. Of course, there are statements which are still at best hearsay. But in the case of Lintang Bidol and in the case of Saldi, for example, they have first-hand information. And if this will be supported by independent evidence, then there is, I think, what is left now to be charged would be electoral sabotage. Because that has not prescribed.
Yeah. Electoral sabotage, where will that will be a case tried
in a
court
case,
of
it's
law?
It's a crime that is provided in the election code, and the penalty is life imprisonment.
And who files that?
Usually, election offenses is the exclusive domain of the Commission on Elections. So that's why the COMELEC has an important role to do in pursuing what happened in 2004.
That's why Sixto Brillante is talking about interviewing Bidol very well and
very
getting
well,
affidavits,
yes.
etc. What is the possible scenario at the end of all of this? Is as Grace Poe was saying, no, asterisk na lang, no?
You cannot return the term of Fernando Poe Jr. has been...
Even if he were alive today,
yes,
no?
It has been served already by President Arroyo on all the acts of... Barroyo are, of course, acts of the president, so you cannot erase those things. But what is important is that if she's guilty of electoral sabotage, then she has to pay for it. And that would strengthen our electoral systems or institutions, that you have to pay for it. And it would be a warning to future aspirants to leadership to stick to the to the principle of fair, honest elections.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you, Dean Amado Valdez, who joins the last segment together with Jerem Gudani. After the break, we'll talk to an ally of former President, now Pampanga Congresswoman Gloria Macapagal-Arroyo. Strictly Politics, we'll be right back. Stay with us.